Russian scientists just announced that they have created a time machine that moves tiny particles a fraction of a second into the past. Meaning that if these scientists are correct, they have just achieved time travel. So how exactly did these scientists do this, and what does it mean for the future of time travel? Welcome back to another steaming pile of potatoes. I'm Charlotte Dobre. On this channel, we take the most interesting news stories on the internet and we make them more entertaining. Hit that sub button and the bell so you never miss one of our videos. Before I get into this one, tell me down there in those comments, what would you do if you could turn back time? Who would you visit? What would you change? Let me know down there. All right, so little disclaimer here. Physics definitely wasn't my science subject of choice. I was definitely more of a biology kind of gal, so I'm gonna do my best to explain physics to you all. Just bear with me for a second, okay? Russian scientists at the Laboratory of Physics at the Moscow Institute of Physics and Technology say they have essentially defied the second law of thermodynamics by creating a mini time machine. No big deal whatsoever. The time machine is built from a basic quantum computer made up of qubits. A qubit is a unit of information described by a 0 or a 1. This information can be stored on an electron. According to the Russian physicists who claim to have built the machine is able to move smaller than atom-sized objects in the opposite direction of time's arrow. I feel like I've lost you already. Come back. Come back. Come back. How about I use an analogy? Everybody likes analogies. The physicist gave the analogy of a break for a game of pool. When the pool balls are scattered, they split in a random way. But these physicists claim that they managed to make the balls reform in their original order inside the triangle. The experiment sought to cause qubits to become more complex, changing the pattern of zeros and ones. Order was then lost, but with another program, they modified the state of the quantum computer so that it evolved backwards from chaos to order. This caused the qubits to rewind back to their original starting point. So it's like you're playing a game of pool, you break the triangle, the balls scatter, and then all of a sudden, they come back to their original triangle shape. Pretty insane, right? This goes against the rules of physics that dictate the direction of events that go from the past to the future. This law governs that everything in the universe must eventually decay. This includes things like our sun, living things, and memes. Eventually, memes get stale and die. Usually with the help of meme review. Shots fired! And according to the second law of thermodynamics, energy does not repeat in an infinite loop. At least, so we thought. So what does this mean for the future of time travel? Well, the scientists found that while working with just two qubits, time reversal was successful 85% of the time. But as soon as they jacked up that number to 3 qubits, the success rate dropped to 50%. That being said, this experiment is making huge waves in the scientific community. It is, in every respect, a breakthrough. I remember when I was watching a TV program like 15 years ago about how cell phones are going to be so small, they're going to be small enough to fit in our pockets someday. And here we are, 15 years later, and we not only have cell phones small enough to fit in our pocket, we have mini computers. This time machine is the first step toward achieving time travel on a grand scale. Who knows, maybe 50 years from now we'll be able to travel to the past, and I'll be able to take back that very horrible joke. This time machine and the findings were published in the journal Scientific Reports. That is all I have for you on this. Tell me what you think of this time machine down there in the comments, as well as what you would do if you could turn back time. For now, I am going to wrap up this video with some comment features. Cat Barf said, just finished eating my fries, love my taters. And your taters love you too, Cat Barf. NKKM said, Charlotte makes me feel a lot better about myself. That makes me happy. Bonnie Lockwood said, did I tell you your background music reminds me of the final music from Saw? Weird. But makes sense. Stephen Will said, hey Charlotte, how are you at coming up with your own material on the spot? Make it as you go, so to speak. Good question. I actually have a ton of improv training. I was part of an improv ensemble for about a year and I've taken a lot of classes, so I'm pretty good at thinking on my feet. Also, most of the time when I look at the second camera, I'm not using a script because there's no teleprompter in front of the second camera. It's only in front of this camera. So you can probably bet that if I'm looking at the second camera, I'm not reading something. I'm just talking directly to you. Cheesecake said, you always make that face, Charlotte. I love it. This face? That's it for this video. Click this playlist to keep watching IO, hit that like button, subscribe, and turn on notifications so I can see you in a future IO video.